हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू दिस नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ स्टाफिंग एंड दिस इज बिजनेस स्टडीज क्लास 12। सो नाउ इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द कंपोनेंट्स और द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ स्टाफिंग। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन द प्रोसेस, सो नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ स्टाफिंग। सो दे आर थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स और द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ स्टाफिंग एंड दे आर रिक्रूटमेंट, सेलेक्शन एंड ट्रेनिंग। एंड स्टूडेंट, इन सेलेक्शन प्रोसेस, सॉरी, इन स्टाफिंग प्रोसेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स, दैट इज रिक्रूटमेंट, सेलेक्शन एंड ट्रेनिंग। एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल अबाउट दीज थ्री। एंड रिक्रूटमेंट, सेलेक्शन एंड ट्रेनिंग मीन्स ऑल दीज थ्री दे मेक स्टाफिंग। ओके, फॉर द स्टाफिंग फर्स्ट यू आर गोइंग टू रिक्रूट द पर्सन, देन सेलेक्शन इज डन and then proper training is given. So let's study in detail what are these three. So what is recruitment? It may be defined as the process of searching for prospective employees and stimulating them to apply for jobs in an organization. So student, we have all discussed in staffing process about recruitment as it is the second step. Now let's see what are the sources of the recruitment. Okay, so there are basically two sources of recruitment, internal sources and the external sources. And by the word itself it is clear, internal sources mean inviting candidates from within the organization. Okay, let's see the definition, means what the meaning of these internal and external sources. So internal sources of recruitment, it refers to inviting candidates from within the organization. Okay, and then means if there is any vacancy in the organization, then it can be filled by using existing employees only, and no outsiders are permitted in internal sources. And so in internal sources there are again two methods of internal sources, and they are promotion and one is transfer. So now let's see what is transfer and promotion. Transfer, it involves the shifting of an employee from one job to another, from one department to another, or from one shift to another shift. And promotion, it means placing an employee to a higher position, carrying higher responsibilities, prestige, facilities and pay. So we have seen the meaning of transfer that on the slide. Now like student, you remember one thing in transfer, that there is no change in the responsibility, salary, status of the employee, only workplace is changed. Student, do you remember while discussing staffing process I gave you one example that there are three departments, that is production, finance and so, and for each department the organization required 10 employees. But in finance department there was 11 employees. So here, because finance department is overstaffed and marketing department it was understaffed, you remember there were 8 employees only. Okay, so now by transfer the shortage of employee of marketing department can be filled by transferring employee from the finance department. And it will also help in avoiding termination, because if there is overstaffing, so means company can't pay people without any work, so for that they can terminate, they require to terminate that person. But because of this transfer the termination is avoided, and these individual, they are not supposed to remove from the job. Means just by transfer you can avoid the termination and removing of the individual. But one thing has to be ensured before transferring, that the employees to be transferred to other job, they are capable of performing that particular job where they are transferred or not. Okay, so it has to be kept in mind. And also student, this transfer, it is horizontal shifting of employees, because there is no change in the position. Okay, they are just changing from one job to another job. Or for making it clear to you all, I will also give you one more example of this transfer. Like suppose transfer of clerk from account departments to purchase department. means suppose there is more of the people in account department, so they can be the clerk, they can be transferred from one department to the another department. So it is, that is why it is said to be horizontal shifting. The level is not changed. Clear? Now the promotion. So it means placing an employee to a higher position, carrying higher responsibilities, prestige, facilities and pay. So promotion, it is said to be a vertical shifting of employees. Vertical means from lower to upper position. Okay, so it is vertical shifting of the employees. And lower job position to higher job position, and it also motivate the employees to work hard and to show their capability, because now you have to show your capability that yes, one is capable of adopting promotion, of taking higher responsibilities. Okay, so this is what promotion is. Now these internal sources, they have certain advantages as well as disadvantages. So what are the advantages of internal sources? Motivates the employees, simple process, tool of training and cheaper. Then what are the disadvantages? Lethargic, lack of fresh talent, low productivity and lack of competition. So let's see the advantages first. So the first advantage says that it motivates the employees. Employees are motivated to improve their performance. Means as in promotion, the employees are offered higher level. Okay, student, here I am talking about the internal sources, and in internal sources I am talking about promotion. So if the person want promotion, means the higher level is offered to them. So this will motivate the employees to work efficiently in expectation of future promotion. Clear? Then it is a simple process. Why it is simple process? Internal recruitment also simplifies the process of selection and placement. So do you remember, student, the selection process? There were so many steps in the process of the selection. So because of this internal recruitment, this internal sources, the present employees are already, they are known to the organization and can be evaluated more accurately than the external source. So that is why it is said that it is very simple and reliable process. Then it is said to be a tool of training, means no wastage of time on employee training and development. So because again here in this internal sources, the employees, they are known to the organization's rule, regulation, and so here there is no wastage of time on the employee training and development. It is cheaper also, the fourth point, cheaper. Filling of jobs internally is cheaper. And why cheaper? Because as in sources of internal sources of recruitment, there is no need of doing advertisement, because you are not supposed to tell externally to anyone. So you can save money over here by not giving any kind of advertisement. Then test, interview, means all the process which we have already discussed earlier in selection process. So that process of selection, it requires lots of money also. So because in internal recruitment, all such things are avoided, and therefore it is said that it is a cheaper, means internal sources, they are a cheaper source of recruitment. So then now let's see the limitations or the demerits of these internal sources. So the limitation, the first limitation says that lack of fresh talent. The scope of induction of fresh talent is reduced. Yes, how it is that? Because you know, when vacancies, they are filled through internal promotion, so now the company, there is limited choice and scope of induction of fresh talent. So this may be possible, this may be the limitation of internal sources, that the company, they won't be able to get any fresh talent. Then लेथार्जिक, द एम्प्लॉय में बिकम लेथार्जिक. द एम्प्लॉयज, वाई दे बिकम लेथार्जिक? बिकॉज इफ दे आर श्योर ऑफ गेटिंग प्रमोशन देन वाई दे आर गोइंग टू वर्क हार्ड, इजेंट इट? बिकॉज इफ सपोज एनी कंपनी दे हैव रूल दैट दे मीन्स दी हायर प्रमोशन एंड ऑल विल बी गिवन टू दी एम्प्लॉयज ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर मीन्स एयर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर ईयर ऑफ सर्विस टू दैट पर्टिकुलर कंपनी और ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सीनियोरिटी. सो डेफिनेटली द एम्प्लॉय विल बिकम लेथार्जी. दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क दैट हार्ड बिकॉज दे आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस पॉइंट दैट इन द कंपनी डेफिनेटली आफ्टर सम टाइम दे विल बी गेटिंग द प्रमोशन. सो आई टू वर्क हार्ड, इजंट इट? देन द नेक्स्ट लिमिटेशन इज लैक ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन. मीन्स द स्पिरिट ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन अमंग द एम्प्लॉयज मे बी हैम्पर्ड. सो वाई इट इज सो? बिकॉज इट द एम्प्लॉयज दे आर लाइकली टू एक्सपेक्ट ऑटोमेटिक प्रमोशन by seniority, so definitely they are not going to compete with anyone because yes, when I know that I will, without any hard work, without any work, I'm going to get the position, the higher position, that why to take so much of pain in the competition and all. Clear? Then the next point says that low productivity, frequent transfer of employees may often reduce the productivity of the organization. So because you must have heard, student, that many of the time some job profile, what happens that the company used to transfer from one place to another place very frequently. So what happens, because of this frequent transfer, the employees, they don't want to work so hard because what they think that what's the use of working hard, I will just for a month or for a year I am here and again the transfer will be done. So, because of this frequent transfer of employees, it can also reduce the productivity of the organization, and it is also one of the drawback of your internal sources of recruitment. So, student, this is all about the internal sources of recruitment, its advantages and disadvantages. And in the next video, we will discuss about the external sources and its advantages and disadvantages. So, thank you, student. And please do like, share and subscribe the video, and in case of any doubt, you can clear the doubt by asking through comment box. And thank you. Take care.